Noam Chomsky, a popular American philosopher who is generally against American foreign policy, has stated in his Who Rules the World? Among states, since the end of World War II, the United States has been by far the first among unequals, and remains so. It still largely sets the terms for global discourse, ranging from such concerns as Israel-Palestine, Iran, Latin America, the War on Terror, International Economic Organization, rights and justice, and others like them to the ultimate issues of survival of civilization, nuclear war, and environmental destruction. In other words, Chomsky is asserting that the United States has, for the past 60 to 70 years, dominated the socio-political relations of our world and in turn has impacted every single one of us in some way or another, even if we don't consciously notice it. And in order to sustain such hegemony, the power of mass media is needed to catalyze confirmation from the masses. Taking this into consideration, we can see the aforementioned process and general ethos through Rammstein's song and music video, America.
It's crazy to think that a band like Rammstein can have so much popularity with such a simple chorus that goes something like this.
We're all living in America, America, it's wunderbar. We're all living in America, America, America.
And it is astounding how Rammstein can say so much with such minimal lyrics. And the minimalism of their lyrics gives more room for interpretation, which fuels the argument that Rammstein are controversial and ambiguous in their reception. And that is exactly why the lyrics incentivize you to think about the products you buy, the media you consume, and the music you listen to. Nevertheless, Rammstein do this by not even explicitly mentioning the themes of globalization, neocolonialism, or consumerism in their song America, and in taking a position of simplicity and minimalism, where we don't necessarily see a specific value judgment about globalization and neocolonialism, they spark controversy, which targets both sides of the political spectrum. Through their music video, and by extension the audiovisual medium, one can argue that they sincerely present notions of nationalism, objective truth, and science as the catalyst of progression, which are all elements that belong to modernity. But one can also argue that they also, somewhat ironically, present these aforementioned elements by adopting a pop culture aesthetic and expressing them affirmatively and excessively, which are inherently elements of postmodernist art and the general discourse surrounding it. In doing so, they are part of a metamodernist space, and I aim to exemplify this through their portrayal of mass media in America. So, Rammstein's music video essentially presents the band singing the song after landing on the moon. We then see the feed broadcasted to TVs across the world, from what seems to be rural and tribal Africa to what seems to be rural Southeast Asia. And within these images, we get a very stark and almost kitsch juxtaposition. On the one hand, we see rural populations who are somewhat unaffected by the advents of progression and modernity with American products, not only hamburgers in their hands and Santa Claus in their vicinity, but also, to an even greater extent, the commercialization and spectacle of the moon landing distributed through mass media. This polarizing juxtaposition gives rise to different types of interpretations. What stands out as the most crucial layer in Rammstein's music video is the power of media representation and how it affects the masses. One can always argue that the symbol of the TV, which generally also connotes broadcasting and distribution, is a sign of industrial progression.
The ability to broadcast the moon landing, which in itself also connotes that same idea of progression to rural parts of the world, demonstrates the ability to bring objectivity, truth, rationality, and technological progression from a live event in outer space to remote areas of the world. Now, that sounds somewhat familiar. It somewhat harks back to how colonialists understood their mission to colonize. The values of modernity, primarily the aforementioned, was the fuel of the colonizer's mission. As Vasant Kaiwar states, the compound term colonial modernity, which is supposed to indicate the limits of a Eurocentric historical perspective that imagines modernity either to replicate the European pattern or to be considered inadequate, distorted, or otherwise a corruption of the original. Within this process, the TV becomes a digital means to reinforce these values to communities that are represented to be inherently at odds with modernist ideas, such as religion, superstition, etc., as opposed to the modernist ideas of rationality and objectivity. Therefore, a modernist would argue that it is the mission of American dominance to bring these progressive values to such communities, to instill these values for the sake of progression and America's interests. However, a postmodernist would say that this is not progression, but some sort of neo-colonial digital domination where mass media becomes a means to shape our identity through commercial products which are at the cornerstone of consumerist and capitalist culture. The reason why mass media is so powerful in achieving this aim is primarily because it creates an environment, that is to say, a spatiotemporal construct, that supersedes and surpasses the confines of reality. In other words, we can refer to Jean Baudrillard's postmodernist idea of the hyperreal and the death of the real, where TV, commodities, and mass media, and the signs and images and the values connoted and denoted through them, become more real than the real itself. In this process, one accepts the reality which is presented on TV and adopts it as their own, and therefore conforms to a reality that follows the hegemonic ideological norms, and thereby mass media manufactures consent. Coming back to Rammstein, the band seems clear with its intentions. It is not only rural societies that might suffer, but the band also clearly bring their own conviction into the song. They are also victims of American mass media. They have to sing in English in order to reach a bigger fan base, as the American pop music industry has a foothold in every corner of the world. And Rammstein reacts to the ideal they attempt to subvert by affirming the mechanisms of the system by using the same operational veracity that Uncle Sam uses. And this also relates to Chomsky's understanding of how the elite aim to manufacture consent through mass media. It is there mass media's function to amuse, entertain, and inform, and to inculcate individuals with the values, beliefs, and codes of behavior that will integrate them into the institutional structures of the larger society. Therefore, the reason why Rammstein is so controversial is because they are blunt with their visual imagery and at points contradictory and ambiguous with their message. However, the reason why most of the band's reception tends to gear towards the postmodernist side is because of, for example, the music video's ending. The camera dollies out from a close-up of one of the astronauts, the lead guitarist in this case, and reveals the studio set. The action of moving the dolly shot out of the initial frame and revealing the studio is a clever cinematic technique, as it connotes how media, entertainment, and general pop culture can function. Beyond the walls of that frame, in off-screen space, there's an ideological mechanism that fabricates your consumer wants and your beliefs. In other words, the technique in itself is a figurative means to present the larger ideological mechanism at play. It is as if Rammstein are confirming our dominant assumption that they are subverting through irony by closing the music video with the aforementioned technique. Nevertheless, Rammstein don't attach an explicit value judgment about American imperialism and neocolonialism in their video, and in doing so, they become stuck in the meta-modernist space. It's up to you to decide.